For the summer of 1906, New York banker named Charles Henry Warren wanted to take his family on vacation. They rented a summer home from George Thompson and his wife in Oyster Bay, Long Island. The Warrens hired Mary Mellon to be their cook for the summer.
Hey, what are you drawing?
I'm drawing our vacation. This is the house.
Wow, this is our house?
Yes.
Where is the window pane?
Oh,
you want to draw the window pane?
Yeah.
Ma'am, snacks are ready.
Wow, Mary made this taste.
Let's have a snack.
Yeah.
I made this ice cream by myself. Would you like to have a taste?
Yes, thank you.
I love it. Thank you, Minnie.
So this one
no
is for
problem.
You. And this one is for me. Mm.
Two times per day.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Let me check on your heartbeat and temperature.
Okay.
Open your mouth.
Quite high.
I can see that you have a quite high fever. My assistant will give you medicine outside. You can wait for us. Thank you.
Thank you, doctor.
Take care.
Warren's daughters became ill with typhoid fever. Soon, Mrs. Warren and two maids became ill, followed by their gardener and another Warren daughter. In total, 6 of the 11 people in the house came down with typhoid. Since the common way typhoid spread was through water or food sources, the owners of the home feared they would not be able to rent the property again without first discovering the source of the outbreak. The Thompsons first hired investigators to find the cause, but they were unsuccessful. Then, the Thompsons hired George Hopper, a civil engineer with experience in typhoid fever outbreaks. It was Hopper who believed the recently hired cook, Mary Mellon, was the cause. Mellon had left the Warrens approximately 3 weeks after the outbreak. Hopper began to research her employment history for more clues.
This is her room. She should be inside.
There's no one inside.
She should be inside. What? She's gone! Where is she?
Run.
Elizabeth,
yeah,
come
Mom.
And eat.
Mom, I'm very hungry, Mom.
Yeah, see, Mary, when
yes?
the food is going to be done.
Okay, 1 second, ma'am.
We are very hungry right now.
Done?
Wow, your food looks so delicious.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes.
This is for you.
I love your cook.
Thank you. This is for you. Please put away your phone while eating.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mary.
Thank
so
you.
What are you cooking today?
I cook Soup!
Soup!
Yes?
Hi, I'm Sofa.
Yeah.
Is Mary Mellon here?
Mary Mellon? It's okay. Let her come in.
Miss Mellon?
Yes?
Miss Madden, I am...
Stop! I know who you are. Stay away from me.
Wait. I just want to ask you, you work as a cook before, right?
Yes. So?
So based on my research, you are probably the cause of...
No!
Wait.
No, you're lying.
No, I just want to...
No, I can hear anyone.
Wait a second. I just want to check on your...
Stop! I don't care, okay? I am not the cause of any disease.
Wait, calm down, Miss Madden.
Sopper handed his research and hypothesis over to Herman Biggs at the New York City Health Department. Biggs agreed with Sopper's hypothesis. Then, Herman Biggs sent Dr. S. Josephine Becker to talk to Madden.
Hi, I'm Sopper.
Hello, I am Herman Biggs and this is my assistant.
Hi. Sir, what can we help you?
Okay, based on my analysis, I have analyzed that Mary Mellon, she has caused disease in every place she worked.
Can we see her picture?
Yeah.
Let me.
This is her.
And we'll pass it to our Dr. Becker.
All right.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Yes.
Are you Miss Mellon?
Yes, I am.
Who are you? Okay, I'm Dr. Becker. And yes.
Yeah.
Or were you like waiting for me or something?
No.
Okay. Anyway, Miss Mellon. I've got your report from Mr. Biggs from the New York City Council, and it seems that there are things that we needed from you, such as such as your urine sample and your blood sample. But you were the only one preparing the food, Miss Malone.
So they're the one who eat, and they're the one who get sick, not me.
Surprising. Well, if you're not guilty, can we at least do some blood sample? Why not?
Why should I?
Why should you not?
Why should I give it to you?
There's no use fighting. It won't hurt.
I'm not sure, but this will hurt. No.
There's no use running, Miss Mellon. We have officials.
No.
Officials!
Mellon was taken to the Wheeler Parker Hospital in New York. There, samples were taken and examined. Typhoid bacilli was found in her stool. The health department then transferred Mellon to an isolated cottage on North Brother Island.
There's no use running.
Well, I'm not running. Can you see?
Well, we caught you. Thank God for the officials. So now we're gonna get your blood sample and your feces.
Sorry, Minnie.
You don't have your fork anymore. So... this won't hurt. Yes.
No!
No, it won't hurt. Mary! Excuse me, miss.
Yes?
Is this the microbiology department?
Yeah.
Okay, so recently there are a few cases whereby there are people dying within 50 range, and it's all caused by this cook, but we don't know what happened. We took her blood sample and her stool, so we're hoping that you can tell us what is inside this thing.
Can you see this?
Yes.
Microbiologists, we do the inoculation, incubation, and some platings to identify the type of microorganism inside the blood. So it will take some days.
Okay then. So it will take some days, but I hope that you can give me the results soon because people are dying, all caused to this cook, Mary Malone.
Okay. Don't worry, we'll find for you.
Thank God.
Okay. See what I found. Oh my god, this is the new bacteria. I think we've already found it. Call Dr. Baker now. Okay. Hello. Dr. Baker?
In 1909, after having been isolated for 2 years on North Brother Island, Mellon sued the health department. During Mellon's confinement, health officers had taken and analyzed two samples from Mellon approximately once a week. The samples came back intermittently positive for typhoid. For nearly a year preceding the trial, Mellon also sent samples of her stool to a private lab where all her samples tested negative for typhoid. Feeling healthy and satisfied with her own lab results, Mellon believed she was being held unfairly. In February of 1910, a new health commissioner decided that Mellon could go free as long as she agreed never to work as a cook again. Anxious to regain her freedom, Mellon accepted the conditions. Mary Mellon agreed that she is prepared to change her occupation. She was then released.
Susie, have you had your lunch?
Of course, yes. What about you?
No, I'm still not eating.
Hi, Mary.
Oh,
hi. Please. I'm just doing my job, you know.
Okay, let me help you.
Oh, sure, thank you so much.
Alright.
Would you like to help too?
Yes! Give it to me.
This is the last one.
The last one, give it to her.
Okay.
Okay, done.
Done.
How long?
3 minutes. Maybe 1 hour?
1 hour is...
I think
okay,
one here.
Pump. Oh, I promise you.
So what are you guys doing?
You're taking
recess.
Yes.
Take a rest. Before the old witch come and school.
You mean the manager?
Yes.
Yeah, I only met her once.
So this is your first day here, right?
Yeah. And this is my first time working as a laundry worker.
How about before this you work as?
I worked as a cook before. Yeah. And it's been my jam.
Yeah. Why you quit from your last job?
There are some reasons, but I can't tell you. Yeah,
you
I'm
can
sorry.
Tell me. We are sister, right?
not yet. We're just friends.
Friends.
We're not best friends. Yeah.
Alright.
Okay. I think being a cooker, you have higher salary.
Yeah, you're right. Exactly. I don't know why they pay us much lower.
Yeah.
Working as a laundry worker, I don't know why.
Why? I don't know.
Is it always like this?
Yes, the manager is so annoying, he's so sneaky, you know?
Really?
Yeah.
I think so.
You can ask her.
You can ask you? I can ask you or
no,
I can
you
ask her?
No, you can ask the old lady.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe she can be here. Okay. Alright.
Are you talking about me?
Oh,
no.
No.
Mary, bye.
No.
Mary,
you wait.
I'm
talking
to you.
Yeah. Okay.
So,
what's
the problem?
No, I don't have any
but
problem.
But I heard that you complain about the salary.
Not me. It might be the other two.
You include one of them.
Yeah. Okay. Let's be honest, ma'am.
Yes.
I think that working as a laundry worker, it's not that good because it pays me a little amount of money. You know, I work as a cook before and they pay me a high amount of salary.
But I think it is enough for you because
why?
It deserves that you have a low qualification and
You're saying that I have low qualification.
Yes.
And I work for a lot of family before.
So that the job for the cook. This is for the laundry. So
but okay, nevertheless, I think that we should be paid a lot more.
But I have to pay for the rent of the laundry.
Well,
which is
that's not my problem. Hello.
So I have to pay you a little bit small amount of salary.
I don't care. If you want me to work here, then pay me a little more.
No, I don't want.
Then you're lost.
Hi, good morning. Miss, it's time for a meal, that's it.
Good morning.
Wow,
looks delicious, it looks.
Yes, we have new workers. Her cook is very tasty and delicious. Enjoy your meal.
Who's good with foods?
Mary, a new worker.
Oh, okay.
Yes. Doctor, let's see your patient.
Okay. Hello, miss. How are you?
Okay, let me check you, okay? Take breath. Take in. Breathe in. Breathe out.
You got such a high fever, okay? Nurse, can you give her medicine?
Okay.
Get well soon, okay? See you.
That's it, miss? Good morning, miss. Can you speak to me? Miss? Miss, wake up. It's time to eat. Miss?
Oh my god, what's wrong with her?
Doctor? Doctor?
Yes?
Doctor, what's wrong with her?
Miss?
Miss? Miss?
She's gone.
She's gone?
Yes, she's gone.
Oh my god.
Good morning, madam. Let's have a meal.
Thank you.
Come, wake up.
Yes, I brought special food for you and your baby.
Thank you.
Okay, welcome.
Thank you.
I got a lot of things I have to do. All these distractions, our future's coming soon. We're being pulled 100 different directions, but whatever happens, I know I've got you. You're on my mind, you're in my heart. It doesn't matter where we are, we'll be alright, even if we're miles apart. All I wanna do is be with you, be with you. There's nothing we can do, I just wanna be with you, only you. No matter where life takes us, nothing can break us apart.
We would like to say
thank you for everything!